said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your Coverage of the Defense, season number 3, for our last best of 3 matchup for the evening. It's 4FC going up against Fnatic EU, where Fnatic EU, they've just managed to get themselves into the semi-finals of the EMS 1, and now they're trying to stay alive here in the lower bracket in the Defense season 3. Let's jump ourselves inside the game. Game's already begun. Draft is up, and co-commentator is in the commentary box. It is Ham Sandwich. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me again. I'm hoping that this isn't our last game tonight. I'm hoping 4FC can bounce back from their loss and come back and show Fnatic that they're all a bunch of noobs and 4FC is going to win the game. But we'll see exactly what happens. So far, Wisp, Batrider, ban.
And Cuddle also being removed, so our three troublesome heroes being taken out. And there goes our fourth one. So Nyx being removed, which means Darkseer gets through. Magnetor will get through. We might look at a little bit more of a teamfight kind of thing and fly. As expected, Darkseer will get to be the first one. While Mag is decent, Darkseer is always better. So much more flexible when it comes to what lanes you're going to work on. If you're going to be jungle, if you are going to be a lane. And even just that presence on the lane in comparison to the Magnetor. Mag's got to get nice and close so we can get that shockwave off. Can't see that nice range where Darkseer can with an iron shell and just hang in the woods. 10 seconds. We'll see if 4FC wants to go with him. Sorry.
I think 4FC will go with Magnus here. Because if they don't, you're giving away Darkseer plus Magnus, and that's like better than just any one of them, obviously. But I think Darkseer plus Magnus. Is like more than twice as good as just Darkseer or just Magnus. The fact that you can combine those two together, well, what can I say? They go for Rubick Lifestealer. So Rubick, sort of versatile, can do a lot of different things. And then Lifestealer we saw, well, we've seen every game, I'm pretty sure, since the beginning of time. But Lifestealer's going to be a big nuisance here. I wouldn't be surprised to see Fnatic pick up a Shadow Demon just to deal with it. Or, I mean, those are generally the two options, the Shadow Demon and Beastmaster. 5 seconds. 4FC had both last game, couldn't deal with it.
I'm actually waiting for the Gyro.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Gyro Ultimate now slows down heroes that are magic immune.
It was actually meant to do that from the start, and the patch log said that it was actually it was broken, the fact that it didn't, so they fixed it, so now it's not broken anymore. But that's a long slow on Nakes when that cooldown does come in. And Gyro, we all know how much momentum he can gain. And when you're going to combine in the Darkseer with the Vakin, with the Gyro ultimate, it just looks to be pretty obvious for what Fnatic want to be picking up. But then again, they might try something different. Fnatic, they're already one game up. They're probably coming in with a lot of confidence into this game too. So they might want to try something a little bit more funky. But in the lower bracket of the defense, trying something funky isn't always the best thing. We get your SD and your Gyrocopter, so we get the double whammy from both of us.
Yeah, I think that makes a lot of sense. You have to deal with the Lifestealer. You have to make him have a tough time hitting things, or else he's just going to go a rampage on your team. But Krilly getting that lone druid, it's gonna. They didn't manage to pick it up last game, but. In this game, it looks like they're going to be successful in picking that up. And that's going to be a great offlane hero, or if 4FC decides to do that aggressive tri-lane with Lifestealer, it lets the Lone Druid stay in safe top area. And in a 1v1 situation, Lone Druid excels against a Darkseer, against a number of heroes that you can throw up against him. So... By getting that Lone Druid on the field, it really does open up the options for 4FC.
Chen now making his way in the ban pool, so we do start this one off with Lone Druid for 4FC. Surprise bear. I'm waiting for it. So 4FC, how are they going to now approach this one? We know they've got a lot of strength, got a lot of tankability, but they also realize that they're dealing with a decent amount of control. As well as a huge amount of DPS and teamfight ability coming out from Fnatic. So they start with banning out what would be it could be aggressive, but it's more than likely banning out against the passive Enchantress. If I'm expecting Fnatic to go aggressive here, then I would be expecting a different style of support hero. Like Enchantress is one of those heroes you can pick up from inside the Dire Jungle, maybe a couple of fun creeps to go your way. But most of the time, like SD would be a setup for something else, and then Gyro right on top of him with that burst damage would be what I'd be looking at if Fnatic want to go aggressive. And now I'll throw Darkseer on the safe lane. But up against Naked Darkseer on the long lane is also quite justifiable for Fnatic. It's just if they want to let both a Naked as well as a lone Druid farm up, and I think the answer to that one would in fact be no. You do not want to have those two heroes farmed up.
Well, it's sort of a one or the other situation in most cases, because what 4FC is going to do, they're going to either tri-lane the Lifestealer or... And I think they're going to aggressive tri-lane to try and keep the Lone Druid safe. So Fnatic sort of has the option of going 3v3 against the Lifestealer and trying to shut down Lifestealer while potentially giving Lone Druid a lot of space, or they can put their three heroes up against the Lone Druid and give the Lifestealer some free farm in the early stages of the game, but really try and control that Lone Druid. So it's not the easiest to accomplish both things at the same time. But again, 4FC is going to be making the same trade. They're going to say, let the Darkseer get a really good start if they put their tri-lane against Fnatic's tri-lane.
Just to throw the question out here, Silencer's now in the captain's mode, isn't he?
Silencer is not in captain's mode.
Wasn't he
not
added?
Until this Thursday. He was, okay. But he's not added in the tournament version.
Right.
And the defense is played on the tournament version, which means that the night of Thursday the 14th will be the first time Silencer gets added. So Friday's game is potentially... Mousesports game is scheduled for the 14th, and it's unlikely that the patch will come before then.
All right. 10 seconds remaining. I was interested. I had an interesting thought in my mind, but I will save it. I will save it until later in this week.
Time. I think Silencer is going to be first ban material.
Yeah, I think so as well, man. We'll wait and see. We'll wait and see how the teams want to deal with him, because no team's really been playing with him, or no team has been playing with him, unless they're classic Dota teams. They probably won't even be very familiar with the hero and the way he works.
Teams have had all week to scrim with him, because most teams scrim with latest version, and Silencer is in captain's mode in latest version, so a lot of teams will see him and know what to do against him, but I think a lot of teams will just say, nope, not this week, time to ban him.
Yep. Well, Fnatic, we're going to go again with the Nature's Prophet, could be back in the hands of Trixie. I approve of his Nature's Prophet. And then we go through the rest of the Fnatic lineup, only requiring one more support hero to come their way, unless Nature's Prophet could be played that way and not be put on the lane again. But I am still looking for an aggressive hero. I'm kind of almost waiting for someone like a Lina or something like that, but that's dangerous when you get a Rubick on the field. But just a Shadow Demon setup, maybe even a Jakiro. Jakiro could work out nicely.
Jakiro does combo really well with Darkseer.
Yeah. Fakir Man have that ice wall there, and in fact our 4FC will Lina take the Lina. So I think they couple up with the Rubick and Lina together, and that, as you were saying before, does allow them to run an aggressive tri-lane. It can come from the Rubick pickup, it also buys time for the Lone Druid to get an ensnare off, or even then just Nakes, Rubick, and Lina all together. Open wounds is enough for Lina to get a stun, or guarantee her getting her stun. Or at least improve the odds. You can't guarantee it.
Well, open wounds also does an interesting thing. It lets Lina actually lifesteal with her stun, and Rubick lifesteal with Fade Bolt. 5 seconds remaining. So, I think open wounds is what makes an aggressive, like, Lifestealer such a great aggressive tri-laner.
Well, Storm Spirit's going to be the pick up here from Fnatic. So we get our mid-solo. It will be the Storm Spirit. Which Nature's Prophet? Well, then again, like we were talking about, who's going to be the aggressive lane on the top? Like, what's going to happen here? Is it Nature's Prophet actually now inside the jungle, which makes us have dual lanes: Darkseer top, Storm Spirit mid, and then Gyro and SD on the bot lane. But yeah, SD's going to be really careful about what he does with that Gyro, If he disrupts them, it's a setup for Lena. It's not a, it's not an escape mechanism. It's actually, it's something that's going to be even worse, unless Lena's already popped the stun.
But even so, that's really scary to do 2 versus 3, especially when the 3 are so aggressive from 4FC.
Yeah. Let's see what we're going to get with 4FC's last one. Should just be a mid-solo. Someone up against the Storm Spirit. Someone that can also buy up into an Orchid and lock down that Storm. That's up, but it's also someone who can deal with the initiation that comes from Storm Spirit. It's difficult to really like put your finger on one, but Beastmaster's going to be it. So we're going to go with, rather surprisingly, 3 melee heroes. This is actually really, really surprisingly 3 melee heroes in this.
3 melee heroes isn't that big of a deal because, I mean, a melee mid solo isn't that tough. Lone Druid's not really a melee hero because he's ranged for the laning phase.
The reason why I say melee is because Ira can kite them. That's what I'm looking at right now. I'm thinking about who here can kill off Gyro. With a Beastmaster Roar, with an Entangle, sure, the chances are definitely increased, but you've got support of people jumping in like Storm Spirit. You've got Nature's Prophet who can TP in, give a mech, give a Prophet ulti, give even a Sprout and Force 4FC to run around, unless they're going to throw out the Axes, at which point that could just be a waste to get rid of a Sprout. I'm just wondering how it's going to work as far as maneuverability during teamfights. That's where my big question comes in.
That's true. I mean, the benefit that Beastmaster will have is that he does have that long-range Roar and long-range Wild Axes, so...
Ooh, level one, are we gonna ring? We do not have a ring. But we've got 3 healing sounds plus tangos. Level 1 Roshan is happening right now by 4FC. 100% guaranteed with that build. That's exactly what they need to get in front of Fnatic. And Fnatic don't have a lineup that they want to check for it. Or an easy lane.
No-tail went TP first. They can't even check with Treants.
Oh, true.
He just went to block those camps. Very first thing.
There's the ping already coming out. That's coming out from Beastmaster, though. Is it just asking for a ward on the high ground? The Dire already
have
one. Oh, Trixie's gonna come in. Trixie's checking the pit.
They're just not gonna do anything. Oh,
Prophet trying to fake the TP inside. Yeah, they know what's going on.
No, I don't know that they do. They're just trying to see if 4FC will come out.
Are they almost out of salves? No, there's still another 4 salves in their lineup. But this is not looking like an easy Roshan attempt. That bear tried to heal up as much as it could. But the salves only heal up a certain amount. This will be level 1 Roshan. And they won't lose a bear for it. Actually, no, yeah, they will. Actually, the bear's on nothing. So it's Nagus demolded to Nakes, and that's going to go the aggressive tri lane.
Yeah, the bear will just walk back to base, and then by the time Krilly gets to top lane, he can...
Not recall
He won't be able to resummon it yet. It's still got 6 seconds, but he can just walk it up there. It's not that big a deal. He's against the solo Darkseer.
Mm-hmm.
And it is going to be this really aggressive tri lane on bottom. And they've got an Aegis on Lifestealer.
We got Nagus on Lifesteal, and we got two and a half levels up on both the supports in the bottom lane too. This is, for me, the bigger problem in this bottom lane. I'm interested to see, though, just how far it really turns into farm and aggression. Pick up, throw down, lean up, warp, nice disruption, perfect target there by Fly. So Lightstrike Array is going to miss. I was talking about that disruption being a problem before. If you're going to disrupt up Gyro, then it just makes it an easier setup for Lena. But... To disrupt Lena.
Disrupt Lena.
So the initial setups from both Open Wounds and Telekinesis both being used at the same time. It means Lena's got nothing to really couple it with. And now Fly, we're going to go again. Lightstrike Array, he disrupts himself and avoids the damage. Lena already threw the stun, and that's a lot of damage being done to Strangby. Almost costing him that Aegis already. Sharp play by Fnatic. And 4FC is going to be aggressive.
Really defensive, and they're being successful at this defensive maneuvers.
And in the meantime, No-Tail. This is the reason why he went TP level 1. Lamest reason in the world, but still a reason why he went TP level 1. Sits on the high point. Oh no, he's going to TP out. Time to farm and stack.
Yeah, he's got level 1 Nature's Call now. So he can do the small camp. Wait until 2 minutes and then TP back onto the high ground if he needs to.
I'm wondering if it was a misclick for him to have TP at level 1. Or if it was completely intentional.
I don't know. Regen's going to be taken here by Lina.
Regeneration. Helps her out a little bit.
Even though Treant was coming to deny it.
Man, good thing for Strangby's already got boots up for him. Which means chasing down heroes like Ira as well as Fly is going to be a lot easier. Well, then again, Ira already showed how much damage he can do to a Nyx once the Rage has already been popped.
And that was level 1 Rocket Barrage. I'm not even talking about level 4 or anything like that. It's...
That's tricks looking on the top. Man, 17 for nil up against a 13 for 1. I really should never be surprised by this. But just the fact that Darkseer can outlast almost anybody in a lane. And then he looked towards Hani in the mid. 15 for 5 up against a Beastmaster who's 19 for nil. At least he's now running that bottle back and forth, but... doesn't look to be the smoothest operation in the world.
Yeah, sometimes you see when teams do level 1 Roshan, you give the Aegis to the mid player just so he can be super aggressive and, like, dive past a tower to get a level 1 kill or... an early kill at least, and then just respawn with the Aegis and run away. Mm. But in this case, they give it to Nyx just to be extra safe, keep him alive.
Finally, Fnatic managed to deward their own jungle, so they're able to start pulling again. Even if that top lane, like 4FC, they haven't done the same thing for them yet. You see Krilly with a resummon. Waiting for that gank to come his way at some point. Catch him out, no bear, and having a very short resummon time. It's Boomski as well as Loco still looking for an opening. They're looking to come back in again, try and block the camp, so they body block it. If the ward's being dewatered, what do? You body block it. And Fly's going to get very frustrated with this. He's unable to pull, he's unable to control the farm on this bottom lane. And because of that, Ira can't get close enough to get the levels he needs or the farm he needs. While Nate's just reeking it in. The difference, though, is the fact that Beastmaster... oh, she did it again, even the middle lane. Like, you always look for that timing with a Storm Spirit before he hits level 6 to see if he's going to get ganked up or not. And the timing for the Beastmaster, because Beastmaster's walking around level 6.5, and he's got, like... he's already got his Roar up and running. So if he feels if he can drop Hani down a little bit lower...
Oh, there's a TP for Beastmaster and Boots, so I'm guessing he's going to go... oh, Trixie's low in top lane, but it looks like...
bottom lane should be it. Bottom lane should be it should just be a quick rotation down, roar him up, find someone inside that jungle, and then TP back to mid so you don't waste too much time. That's this bottom lane right now. It's actually maybe they're just happy with it. It's like we got Nakes up on 30 for 14. Why wouldn't you be happy with that?
The Gyrocopter is controlled. Yeah, 2-0 and only level 3, so.
Finally able to pull, and then finally Boomski also comes in. Gyro's trying to keep that aggro. But Boomski being a pain in the ass to him. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, looks like Hani going to have a crack. No, probably going to TP in for this too. I was thinking about it. Oh, Trixie. Man, how low on life can you get?
That's what I'm worried about. I'm worried about the TP from Beastmaster just roaring Trixie if he gets too far... at least too close to the tower. So he's pretty low mana as well.
Actually see him buy up 2 clarities. And we'll send him up towards the top lane once the courier gets back to base. Until then, it'll just be Sol Ring and Iron Shell. And doing it from range. Even if the bear is going to scout out for him. One entangle and Trixie's dead. And Trixie could have known that too. Runs up in the tree line. But then again, he's almost using himself as bait because Hardy's now up on the top with the regen rune. Wants to jump it in. There's already our Sol Ring. If he puts it up on Hani, which he has done so, yeah, there's the Iron Shell damage. Jump quickly, jump out, Trixie. Getting attacked by the tower. They're going to get himself away. Luckily for him, fast enough before Rubick managed to finish his TP in towards the top.
Hani got hit on maybe the first or second jump by the Spirit Bear there. So his regen was essentially wasted and he was stuck at 100 mana.
Well, looks like mid lane's having some issues. Fly, disruptions there. It's just up on Nose, and Nose still taking damage from the tower at the same time. Boomski's here as well. No tail. Well, he's looking to TP in front of him. He's still going to TP by the looks of it. Nose is on the run back out again. No tail cancels. He's taking too much damage from the Light Strike array. Looks like he's going to get his salve as well. Just want to point out that Aegis the Immortal did nothing at the end of the day. It was just the experience and the gold. Strangbeard never got killed in the bottom lane when he had it. And now with these supports roaming around, Gyro comes in close looking for more damage, but then he's in trouble too. Light Strike Array cannot be avoided. And Nira, too much damage on him. First blood being spilled in the bottom lane. Sorry, I saw it, Ham. You can't give items.
Yeah, I only have one set left to give, so you better see all but one kill this game.
Well, depending if we get it with third game or not, we might need it for the...
I guess that's true.
Mm-hmm. It's almost like encouraging me to fail.
A little bit.
I'm not sure about this, man. Well, Nortel back into farming. 1,500 gold up on him. So still, as you said before, Hand of Midas. Doesn't matter if it's logical to go a mech. In this scenario, it's not. In this scenario, it's a lot more logical to go that Hand of Midas. Because he's going to need all the items in the world to try and win this and push this late game on the side lanes. Trixie. Well, coming a lot closer towards Krillie's bear than I thought he'd really want to. As a support returns towards mid lane. Beastmaster all with a follow-up Light Strike Array. I wonder if Lina's also here just so she can leech off that experience to get to level 6. She's, even with that initial hit, like she hit 2.5 levels from that Roshan. She's sitting at just over 5 levels now. Denied. Which is kind of amusing when you look at both ASD and the fact that Rubick is also only level 4. The supports of Fnatic are actually out leveling for FC.
Well, there really is only one support from Fnatic. That's the thing.
Cool, Norris. Prophet Oli, a lot of damage. Light Strike Array. Wrong position. Catcher is there, though. Shadow Poison won't latch him.
Light Strike Array, at least there, forces Storm Spirit to back off. So, even though it doesn't hit, probably saves at least a little bit of damage on Beastmaster there.
Mm-hmm.
Trixie again, just skipping creeps, making sure this bear is continually needed to be respawned. It's always low HP.
When you go up against a double Iron Shell, you're always going to lose that life point. Or lose those life points. Here's correct grammar.
It's just a little bit worried about getting entangled. Doesn't want to be too close.
Interesting now with Beastmaster making his move. Gonna move down the lane. Hawk to scout out with, but then again, trees will instantly find him. And the double damage is already worn off, so 10-minute rune up on the top. Haste rune going the way of Fly. And is he gonna run up top? Yeah, he's gonna make that move for Quelly. Or not.
Yeah.
He can't make up his mind.
Hani is sitting in the fog here, waiting to go on Krilly, but they're not finding an opening. Krilly is doing a good job keeping the lane at his tower. He's even been stacking that small camp just to get a little bit of extra gold and to keep the lane where he wants it.
Kind of surprised about this. It's almost a bit of a waste. There's our disruption cooldown as well. Noah's going to cop a lot of damage from this, combining up with that Prophet Oldman. Lina will get sniped out, and then over to Noah. So two heroes on the sidelines of 4FC, and then Loco. Hani with the last points of mana he's got, jumps in, pulls him back, and then Nortel takes his life. Again, Nature's Prophet with the kills.
And he picks up that Hand of Midas, so he's looking to get lots of money.
It's just not the same with that Trixie. I don't know. Dire's
middle tower is well, we'll see what item build he goes. Maybe that'll restore your faith.
Maybe. We'll see. We'll see. Well, Trixie, a little troll for him up on that top lane. Even though that Iron Shell damage is still pushing down Krilly's bear, he's going to resummon in a moment. And then we go running away. Stick charges up as fast as possible. They can go Tranquils in 14 seconds time. And then Boomski will rotate up towards the top lane. Looks like he's got help. Loco's coming up here. He's still got these two healing salves. hasn't bought up boots. We're 11 minutes in and we've got no boots. Oh, Lifestriker Ray, Trixie. Oh. He turned around to pop off a secondary Iron Shell. Boomski, he needs his slave, but he's already... not only enough. Prophet going to TP him. Purge up on Boomski. Turn around and fire. Prophet will come in. TP, there's nothing to stop him. There's a disruption. There is something to stop him. Prophet still not TP again. He's faked it twice. He's got to go at one point. Faked it thrice. And still not going. No tells, just farming. He's trying to be a presence up on that top lane without being a presence on that top lane.
Just reminding 4FC that he can come in if he wants to.
Mm-hmm. Error. I love it when Storm Spirit's Static Remnant always just turns into an error symbol.
Yeah, there's something up with that. I noticed it in a game a while ago.
Yeah, things are 100% of the money, huh?
But I'm sure that that is a known issue and will be fixed shortly.
I'm sure it will. I'm sure it will. So, Fnatic, are they going to add some pressure towards the top with Hani rotating up? And it's a Nimviz rune. I'm pretty sure the answer to that is yes. Especially when Trixie... Well, he just saw him. He just saw him. Loco picks him up, throws him down, but actually helps out Trixie more. Now he can Iron Shell already up on Hani. The bear comes in and Storm goes out. Last points of mana to escape again. A snipe off and another support hero for Fnatic.
And Lifestealer wasted a TP there. No, he didn't. I don't know what I'm talking about. I thought I saw somebody TP in for 4FC, but I think I was just hallucinating.
There's all those Prophet TPs in, man. Yeah. It's just sitting on your mind. Now, this courier's got to be really careful. One, because it's Ramnaught. You don't want to risk Ramnaught. But also because of walking around with a relic. If Prophet sees this, yeah, Prophet's going to TP in. The courier, get him out of there! Get him out of there! The relic transferred over. So at least then Trixie gets tangled up. And Darkseer, Laguna Blade is up there for Boomski. Finally is level 6 with that death of the Darkseer. So can turn around with a little bit of magical damage. Same time, Era is pushing out that mid tower and try and take it out. But TP comes in. And Beastmaster will put an end to that. But overcommitment by Fnatic on the top lane.
Yeah, they're a little bit greedy for the courier there, and the courier did manage to deliver the relic successfully.
So even if they did kill it off, it wouldn't have done anything else. Man, they just gave 2,000 experience to 4FC with those two kills.
That's a lot. They're going to take some of it back by stealing this stack. So Honey picking up a lot of CS here.
Well... he needs it. He needs to get into that Orchid as fast as possible.
With those two given up kills in top lane, Curly's actually sort of boosted towards this Radiance even faster. Sitting at 900 gold right now.
Well, if he can take the farm off this top lane, he's been looking pretty good for it. A lot of TP supports coming up. The Entangle's already gone off on one creep and Fortification. Force jump away. There's already the slow coming out on Fly. And a first hit Entangle. Everything going the way of Krilly. And with that kill, that should be... oh, he's still 100 gold short, but doesn't matter. Nose chasing down Hani. Raw will pop for this one. He's got Axe available too. Hani's got ulti. And gets down the hill and away. And then TP straight back to base. How much it just continues to be given away right now on that lane. Dire's top tower has
been denied. And that's Radiance.
Mm-hmm. So we get the Radiance Burn push coming at 15 minutes in. And now on bottom lane, Boomski going to TP out to safety. Not fast enough though. Era with the call down the barrage. It's enough damage, and now Fly trying to push out the T1 tower in mid. While Trixie thinks about holding the top. But I don't like his chances. This push power that comes out from both Strangby as well as Krilly. And how many points have we got up in the aura? 2 points up in the Inner Beast. That's a lot of damage towards towers at all times. Trixie back wall. Nicely done. Towers to be brought down. It's just, there's no follow through from wall. And then TPs go out. Just trying to stall them up. Strangby TPs in towards the middle lane.
Oh, Trixie just got rooted.
Well, top lane. Oh, he's going to run. He's got Surge. Radiance Burn. Radiance Burn. Radiance Burn. He's just out of range. Radiance Burn back in range. Cannot run from bears.
I shouldn't have told you about that. You'd have missed it.
haven't missed anything yet. Prophet looking to TP in towards the middle lane. But decides not to at the end of the day. Goes back inside his jungle. And he's going the same build. He's going the same build as what Trixie did. We are going to go into that Shadow Blade. It's the new thing, man.
Oh, honey. Ultimating himself from the mid tower all the way to the bottom rune to try and pick off Lina, but just short.
He just bottles up anyway, gets up the illusion rune. Can jump back in again for Boomski. If he feels that stack is happening, he might even guess it. And there goes Loco, and yeah, Static Remnant, he wants to look.
He can see it now.
Yep. He knows what they're doing. But he's waiting for something else. He's waiting for the drums to arrive. Wait, the hell, that's for, for Gyro.
Eric can just steal the stack if Fnatic put a bunch of heroes there, but it looks like 4FC and have smoked up everybody but Beastmaster.
Initiation Central. And because they got that Static Remnant there, it gave off some vision in 4FC. Well, I don't have enough movement speed to catch up to the Gyro. And if he needs to, we can pop that drum charge.
So pretty sure this bottom tower is doomed, though.
Yeah. Well, let it go. Let it go. We've got Storm Spirit pushing up the middle lane. We've got top lane, which is going to be Prophet, as well as Trixie adding pressure to the tier 2 tower there. And Era, able to TP out in time. Nothing can stop him. So a tier 1 for damage on a tier 2, in fact, two tier 2s, is what they're looking at as a trade. But then again, 4FC might just say, you know what, you want to damage our tier 2s? We'll just take tier 1 and tier 2 at the same time. Nope, that's not going to be their answer. Nose comes middle lane, and Hani just jumps him. Picks him up, throws him in, cooldown coming through, and then goes Nose. Got the roar off in time, but it doesn't stop the barrage from doing his job. But Era, in range of the tower, held in position. Means that follow-up damage from Loco is going to be enough, and then up towards our top lane. Prophet Aldi bouncing through, and cruelly brought an Aix with him when he TP'd up towards the top. And Trixie burning. Tries to turn around to fight this one, then realize, wait, this is more than I really bargained for. Iron Shells quickly, but it's already dead. He's waiting for Hani to return and help him out, but never really happened.
Yeah, No-Till. Just going to do all he can to just... He's preventing a lot of this farm from 4FC, but he's going to give some of it up in these treants. He just picked off that tiny little camp there. I guess that's the big camp, but picked it off. But now the bear's just going to hunt down these trees to get the 14 gold each.
Easiest way to play a bear, man. Take any farm you can. Well, in No-Tail, bottom lane. Love the fact he's already got the Nature's Prophet Shadow Blade. Beautiful. That's the best split pushing in the game. But Boomski's going to stop it pretty fast. Same with Nose. That is a nice strength for the 4FC lineup. Whenever it comes to good momentum coming in, you got a Light Strike Array, you got a Slave to Fly out, you got Beastmaster with Axes, you got Rubick with Fade Bolt, and then you get the Radiance Burn on top of that. And if they need to, they've got the next Infest. So between all of this, any kind of momentum which Fnatic gains in the lane, it can be quelled by just a couple of these heroes. The only downside is if they get caught out too far, and they lose a couple of these heroes, then it's going to end. And now the Purge, need an Entangle on something. Storm Spirit's going to jump up, pulling back in again. Cat's already managed to hit there on Cruel. He's a lot of damage coming his way. And now 4 points in TP stolen by the Rubick.
There you go. He can get himself anywhere. He can just be Nature's Prophet now.
Not a bad thing to have. An initiating Nature's Prophet too, not a farming one. Unless he wants
to
be that.
He can fake TPs all over the map.
And then Fnatic's like, sweet, I'm getting support. No, I'm not. Strang B, trying to get close enough for an open wounds, but cannot catch up to that Gyro.
I wonder what it looks like on the map. Like, if you TP as Rubick beside somebody, is it just the Nature's Prophet branches coming out of the ground?
You would assume so.
You could just totally fool somebody. They just saw like TP right beside a hero, and they're like, oh, it's just Nature's Prophet coming to join me. And no, it's actually Rubick.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm still waiting for him to use it so I can see the animation. He's not doing it. He's failing it. Come on, man. Come on. No-Tail as well as Era already pushing at the bottom lane. He's just hanging inside the jungle. He's like, no, don't worry, man, I can TP. Not a problem. He's also in the Rosh pit. No, we've got illusions there. Strangby continues to farm up on the top. See up to now. Man, are they... I was thinking there might even be a bottle that could be running back and forth with this prophet ulti. Just to go next level on nose. Spam out everything he's got. Take the bottle back to base. TP back again. Bring the bottle with you.
Yeah. But, Hani here is really, really close to an Orchid. He's just the recipe cost away, so 200 gold.
I love these trees. They're just surrounding the Hawk. Trying to bring it down. They know the vision's already there, so the Hawk will pop. But this Radiant Spear on the front lines again. No one wants to come in close on this. So let the T1 tower go in the mid. Well, Eero continues to farm up on the bottom lane. While Hani continues to push up on the top lane. Is that his full Orchid too? Yeah, it is. Full Orchid coming towards the top. Whoop, there's the Prophet ulti. It was the trees. I saw it at the end. Easy pickup, and he brought Strangby with him. And now they can look towards Roshan again. It's been kind of ignored for a while.
I'm not sure exactly if Fnatic can actually deal with this right now. They have trees coming in. I think, oh, they just died. But I'm pretty sure Fnatic knows 4FC is doing Roshan.
Yeah, that's why they just take tier 2 tower on the top lane. If they don't feel like they can contest it, and without a Gyro's ulti, they cannot contest it. All they gotta do is just keep adding pressure towards all the lanes. Push in through the top. Saw a fake TP there from Notal. He's trying to say, yo guys, I'm gonna push in through that bottom lane. And he never did. And then continues to push out through the top. So Shadowblade and TP. He's going jungle.
It's another Aegis for Lifestealer. I think they're probably going to use it a little bit more aggressively this time, especially now that Lifestealer has that Armlet and Desolator.
Well, they kind of hope to. The only downside is this Orchid is already up for the Storm Spirit, and one of Prophet's also going to build the same. We get double Orchid, we get the Silence, it'll never have Rage, it'll always be Amplified. Things can also go wrong for Beastmaster as well. Never get a Roar off. All depends on who they want to focus on. And the push is definitely coming from 4FC. They're making a beeline for the mid. They don't want to give time for this split push to happen. The trees are going to help out, and Prophet's going to pop this ulti right now. Try and save this push in the mid. Decent chunk of damage through the heroes already, but the tier 2 tower is gone. Cannot stop a bear from pushing, especially when it's got Hyperstone and Radiance up and running.
This is a really, really strong push. Lone Druid actually has a Gem of True Sight now as well. So the Shadow Blade from Nature's Prophet is going to be a little bit less effective, as well as any warding done on the map.
The only difference is the fact that Lone Druid isn't the one who initiates on Notal. Counter pushes Notal. Like, he's up here right now on the top lane, but Notal will easily see it coming. The ganking heroes comes from Lina, it comes from Rubick, it comes from Beastmaster as well as Nakes.
Illusion. Yeah, but at the same time, it's going to be the Lone Druid that's going to live through these pushes and live through these team fights. And I think that's what 4FC is going to look to do soon, is they've got all the tier 1s, mid-tier 2 they just took, and it's now time to sort of group up as 5. We've got our Lifestealer where we want him. Lone Druid getting really, really close to that Assault Quirus. He's just a few creeps away. Maybe that's what they're waiting for, and then they're just going to go for an all-out push.
Mm-hmm. And, well, there's our momentum top lane. They're sniping the bear. Orchid up on him. Sprout as well. Hold the bear in position. No possibility for a resummon. It does go down. But they will resummon it nonetheless. Couldn't resummon it during the engagement. Man, he's 100 gold away from having the Assault Cuirass up on the bear. And he's going to get it too. Tier 2 tower is going to be brought down by 4FC. And once the Radiance flies out, there'll be no stopping 4FC's push inside the base. They really just look way too strong right now. How long we got before Aegis is going to be worn off? 3 minutes time. Yep, 4FC, they're making a move. Into the base they go. Might even be worth it for Quilly to hand the Hyperstone over. Actually, no, not to go in that deep, but Tier 3 tower goes down. Strangby straight into the melee racks, focusing up with the bear. There's no good position for a blink into a vac just yet, but if they kill off this bear, man, Strangby comes straight in, but there's your wall up and running, trying to go for Boomski on the back end of play. So Boomski just on the edge, the Roar holding, Harney out of position. Boomski might go down, and Harney actually able to hold himself away to safety. Aegis has popped, the melee racks is also gone too. And now Strangby on the move back out again. So maybe not, TP out inside the rage, they cannot stop him. And now the Iron Shell is stolen, but Harney staying right on top of him. So double kill for Harney. The rest of the heroes trying to TP out. Double VAC counts out the double TP. And then straight on top of Nose. Notail blocks him in. Can now profit ultimate. They'll need the damage to bring down Krilly. Three heroes on the silence. They might take a rank. It's going to cost him, though. Era. Trixie, back him, back him. Stolen.
Oh, Star Spirit got it.
Stolen. Jump right in front of his nose. And then Krilly is going to go down. Kills the gem before he dies, though. But with four heroes down and Lone Druid on the sidelines, they can't probably know. Well, does he have buyback? Yeah, he does. Only just.
He didn't actually get the AC for that fight.
Well, Strangby raging up, but he's already been purged, slowed down, forced to infest. Realize inside a tree. Also realize the fact that flat cannon was going to kill off most of its creep way pretty fast. I really feel like Fnatic want to go back in again. I got one Orca that is just itching to be used by Harney. And Tier 2 Town will be a return. And there's the Surge in, trying to get Era closer. Storm Spirit, long jump! And the Orca, call down, coming right on the Strangby. No way to get out of this one, especially when you back in again. One down, two down, maybe to come through. Profit, Sprout will hold Rubick in position. The mech charge will pop off from the Beastmaster, but not before Rubick. Yep, there he goes down. Homing missile chasing down the Beastmaster. Buyback, Nakes and Lina. They do not want to lose Arrax. But it cost them dearly to do what they just did.
That's, I'm sort of at odds in this game. Radiant clearly have a big advantage in terms of experience and gold, but...
Holy crap!
Experience especially.
Yeah, I just looked at the experience. Okay.
But they're down... Arrax, so it's sort of anybody's game at this point. 4FC can, like, with that one barracks down, means they don't have to worry about one lane. They've got like a ton of space here. They've basically bought themselves some space to try and get back into this game. And if they win a fight, it's not going to be difficult for them to just go in and take another barracks.
Mm-hmm. The only downside they have is the fact that going up against Nature's Prophet, and when it comes to split pushing, Nature's Prophet is the king. Next to Tinker. A little bit of sight being able to be claimed, and 4FC can take the double stack, which Gyro was trying to set up. He at least has enough to finish up his Mana Style now. So we get Mana Style up on him. Nature's Prophet buys a full Scythe device. So we get the Sheep Stick, so it's not actually focused here from Notail on pushing. For him, it's more important to have the engagements. There's a quick recall from the bear. All the time that it took to cast. Yeah, Shadowblade TP. Hide in the tree line. See, this is what you can do. You could never do this without a Shadowblade. The movement speed lets you run away so damn fast from the rest of the heroes that are trying to gank you up. And you remain invis while you TP out. Well, I'm pretty sure there wasn't a secondary gem purchased up.
Not yet. I think it would have still been on cooldown. It may be off cooldown now.
Oh, check it right now. And we have a bomb. And it's the fourth panel, isn't it? Yeah, gem. Yeah, one in stock. Off cooldown. There goes tier 2,
but
man, that was fastly blocked.
Which team are you clicked on?
I'm clicked on 4FC. Yep, it's on cooldown. Notail, Sprout's trying to hold him out for now. Focusing again on this bear. Trying to bring it down, it's not using the Orchid, and there goes the cooldown. Kind of feeling like the rest of 4FC were a little bit closer towards this. But they weren't. And that AC up on the bear made it even harder for Fnatic to try and bring it. But that Darkseer now with an Aghanim Scepter. If he can get a copy of Nakes before he gets that rage up and running. Obviously, you can't copy him then. It's going to be very, very different. There's your back. There's your wall. Didn't get a copy of Nace, but a couple of other copies. But very, very quickly, both supports being focused off. And then now the bear plus the roar. Harney will go down, but at the same time, we've got Fly getting entangled and Era doing a lot of damage. Bear still wants out of here. It's low on life, and well, SD will take a fall. Menasar breaks out from that entangle, and with the Iron Shells, a lot of damage, but Krilly still not dead just yet. Notail on the edge of it. Trixie backs him back in again. Notail, attack him, gets him, double kill for Notail. And then TP's out to safety. Four for the price of two. Three, sorry.
Getting the Storm Spirit was a big pickoff there, but for a seed, like, their support heroes die so fast to Storm Spirit just zipping around. Like, the Orchid, every fight goes out on Lina. Lina doesn't get any spells off.
Well, she's the chain stunner. Like, where's the other stunts? They're going to rely on the Entangle Chance. They're going to rely on that Roar. There's no other lockdowns apart from Lina, and Lina's cooldowns on those things are so damn low, you can cast off two, if not three, during the length of that engagement.
Yeah, and a Laguna Blade's going to come out if you don't silence her, and that's probably going to go on Storm Spirit every fight. But Storm Spirit having that Lickin' Sphere now, it's a little bit tougher to bring down.
Yeah, how do you really initiate on him if you're like, well, how many stuns have you got? You try Telekinesis, instantly stomped. You try Roar,
There's really not enough targeted spells on Forest Sea. They need everything to hit, so... And the fact that Lina gets silenced is just making it really, really tough to bring down a lot of these heroes.
But how do you protect her?
You can. I mean, Storm Spirit's just going to zip on her every fight.
Well, looks like he's also checking out for Roshan. One Static Remnant going down.
Lina's got to be careful.
Lina's going to be dead. Storm didn't jump it, though.
Zip, zip, zip.
Yep, there goes the zip. There goes your Orca too. So silenced up, a little bit of poison, and the purge to ensure the kill. And Lina goes down the second Roshan spawns up. And at the same time, Notel, he's adding pressure towards the top lane. They're splitting 4FC across the map. And then again, at the same time, I'm also looking at Strangby getting closer and closer towards having a full heart.
Yeah, he's got one now. He just... Oh, no, he's...
He's still short.
15 gold. 15 gold away.
Only just. But you do wonder. There's the Infest into Beastmaster. Blink Dagger up on the Beastmaster too. That's one way to surprise Harney. And Harney's going to feel pretty confident with that Lincoln Sphere up and running, so he'll probably push up this lane. He just won't be expecting that extra damage. Is there a Blink up on... Nope, Rubico do it the old-fashioned way, walking in.
This is gonna have to be really quick.
Oh, there's Rubik. He's in close. And Storm, quick jump. Lickin' Sphere gets triggered too. Just cancel his ulti jump. And Storm Spirit moves back very, very quickly. Same time, you see Nature's Prophet, man. You've already given him a Scythe Device, and now he's walking around with 3,700 gold. If we look at Monkey King bars, if we look at pure damage coming out from him, I still want to see that Mjolnir.
Mjolnir.
Yeah. I want to see it for multiple reasons. I want to see because I want to see the shield up on Gyra. I want to see that from Era. But I also want to see it because it's such a fast pusher. With that lightning damage and the attack speed you get, you push so quickly into bases, it forces supports to rotate back very, very quickly to deal with the amount of pressure you add. And that gives more time for Storm Spirit to go around and also more space for him to gank up. Supports TP back. So what happens from there? You got space to kill off the big heroes, so don't go with them.
It does give you a lot of those things, but I think Nature's Prophet in this situation, he's gone Desolator, which is also a fast push item, helps you take down those towers.
Mm-hmm. Also the negative
and
armor, so we go with that.
Will help you against Lifestealer and Beastmaster. Strength heroes are especially affected by armor lowering items.
And Trixie, are you really building into a Refresher, or is he looking at Lincoln's as well?
A Refresher's a great item on Darkseer. Usually you see a Blink Dagger first, though. Just to set up that perfect wall, but...
But you can't get a second illusion from a wall, can you?
Yeah, you can have two illusions, if they're from separate walls.
You can? Okay, cool, go with it. Make it happen. Make it so. Make the bear die on top lane. Damn, look at that damage of the Desolator. And the missile's going to hit him too. The Roar will come out, and wow, that's a lot of quick rotation in. You knew the Nakes was inside the Beastmaster before, and this time it happened again. And Era. Mana Star will just hold the bear out
Manta.
And then TP out. They cannot stop him. They cannot get in close enough, even if the Hawk could see him.
Yeah, they could have used Wild Axes to chop down the trees, but I think they might have been on cooldown.
They just had no stun. Lina was back at base. In the meantime, they keep getting split pushed.
Yeah, but I think this is okay because right now Fnatic can't really enter the base. Roshan's actually been out for a long time. I'm surprised neither team has committed to it.
Well, each time they think they're going to go for it, there's going to be one hero on the sidelines. But Roshan is being started up by Quilly now. And Nature's Prophet, well, he doesn't have buyback because he bought the Desolator. And that's Roshan. They can't stop it. Pick up. It's only on a Darkseer Illusion. But Roshan's already taken. So Aegis the Immortal and Cheese this time around too. Remember, we had that level 1 Roshan. Which means 4 FC at 37 minutes in. Getting Aegis up on the Aegis on Lifestealer. And the Cheese
the
on
cheese
the Lone
Druid.
And they want to try and push it. They want to take a secondary Rax, but Notel's not going to let him have it. There's top lane momentum already being given out. Ira's going to come up here to give it to him again. And then they'll TP back to try and hold this. But Notel's already given that momentum towards the bottom lane. Prophet Aldi will slow this push.
To come back here. They have to.
Yeah. But Prophet Aldi will. The Prophet Aldi will keep those other lanes pushed out. So if 4FC's got to decide right now, can they push in on this? And they're already deciding now. You see him falling back. They're waiting for the next creep wave. Bottom lane's pushing in, top lane's pushing in. And Fnatic have an Aegis the Immortal, and Trixie, I think, actually, he's got enough money to buy up a refresher. Oh, no, he's short. He's just short. He's just short of the refresher.
Yeah, I don't...
Storm.
Oh, here comes...
Long jump. Boomski just wants to snipe. Jump around, jump up, jump through, and finish off the job. He does do so, but picked up. Roared as well. Fade bottled out. Is it all for a buyback? Yes. Is it all for something else? Yes, all for a buyback. Cooldown's going to come in. They're just trying to bait 4FC to engage. No's going to get hit by that, and there's the wall. Strangby, he's caught inside the wall, and then Storm Spirit comes back in again. Aegis on the sidelines. Who's that Hex on? It's on top of the Bear. The Bear, they've got to get rid of this AC Aura. Maybe they can do so. The Bear's low on life. Bear is now dead. Krilly does have a resummon. Is he going to use it before he dies? Yeah, he will. He brings in the Bear. He wants the Aura back. Trying to pick down Harney, but Harney, Aldi's back inside the base. No doubt. Look at the life! He's on 65 HP! While Gyro stands on the front lines. No's on low life, and Trixie chasing down two of the heroes. Maybe even three. Storm in again. Now onto Loco, but Loco takes the Storm ultimate. Doesn't have a lot of mana to play around with this, though, and Trixie finds him inside the tree line. Enough damage pickup. Iron Shell wears off at the same time. Vac damage kills. Lina only one alive now for 4FC. And Fnatic will make
right
their play.
The Lina died right at the beginning of the fight, so it's not like Lina survived. It was a five kills there for Fnatic.
And you see Noritel just moving through the top. Nakes buyback. It's not going to be enough. They need more. Noritel's looking for a kill. That middle lane push is what I'm all worried about. Not just this push from Notel. Yeah, there's the Beastmaster. There's more. That
the
should be enough.
Buyback as well.
I prefer not to use all three. But Harney would also prefer to kill someone up before they have that extra buyback. Coming in with a double damage. Sees Boomski. Is he going to jump him again? Strangby and Norris. That Infest still there. There's a jump.
Here comes Annie.
Starting on Boomski with a double damage. The Orc is going to snipe him off. Even if the cooldown didn't do it. And then, already starting off on Nose, reducing that armor of his from Notel with a Desolator. Open wounds, then again Mana Star just keeps completely repels this initiation. Blink, Roar, Era, there's that disruption very quickly up from the Shadow Demon. So three heroes on the sidelines, four heroes on the sidelines, about to make it a fifth with Strangby going to go down too. And the Darkseer Wall, they're fighting the middle of that the entire time. So counter-racks now happens from Fnatic. And Prophet's even going to TP in to say hello. So one Rax to go, and now they're going to go straight for the GG. Looks like Notel wants it. He's already starting off on the tier 4 towers. Well, Harney's focusing up on the Rax in the mid, just in cases. Lone Druid is back alive again. This Bear towards the front line, stands up on Trixie. But that Bear's got to be careful. It can go down. In fact, no, he's calling the GG. He says this is over, and 4FC's run in the defense is now over. They get eliminated in the lower bracket, and Fnatic will advance to face up against Na'Vi. In the next round, the lower bracket. Trixie. Refresher wall. It's letting Harney do what he's doing inside the base. So, we know one of our lower bracket. Round two matches. We still don't know the rest of it, though. There's more matches going to be coming up. DD versus Mouse, yet to be played. Team Liquid have already managed to advance themselves into round two, so we know it's going to be Team Liquid going up against either DD or Mouse. Win the upper bracket, the winner's bracket final. Dignitas still going to play up against Noru Tidehunter in the semi-final. Before we know the opponents of Virtus Pro. And as far as EMS, guys, EMS starts tomorrow. There'll be some awesome games coming out for that one. If you don't know the details, head yourself over to joinota.com. You can just click on that little coverage tab and it'll bring you to what you want to see. And that's going to be the grid. And we can see who's advanced through. So it looks like there's still KP playing up against Noru Tidehunter. But Na'Vi advanced with Empire. VP will be playing up against Fnatic. So it'll be Na'Vi either up against Noru Tidehunter or up against KP. And VP versus Fnatic. And then the winner of those two matches will play up in a best of three grand final. All of that starts at 19 CET tomorrow. So check out JD for all the schedule, all the timing, all these details you can find out there. And Ham Sandwich, last but not least, big thanks for you for coming on tonight. It's always great to not be talking to myself.
Yes, go get a good night's sleep. I know it's late in Europe right now.
Yeah, it is. It is. But for all those people over there in America, when you're just coming home, you're putting your tea on, don't worry. The restream of everything that's happened today will be starting off in just a couple of moments' time. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all tomorrow for ESL's EMS1. Should be awesome. Let your friends know. It's going to be a good casting. Just on this live stream. Me and Kawa. It's going to be great. See you then.
I said good day, sir!